Western Union is widely used by Cubans in the U.S. to send remittances to their relatives in the Caribbean nation, cash transfers that send billions of dollars into the island each year. Economists say punishing Western Union's Cuba partner, FinCimex, and an eventual end of this service would have an impact well beyond the Cuban government. This could actually be the rope around the neck of average Cubans, because in the first place, it will not allow them to receive funds through official channels. So this will affect the average citizens who directly receive the remittances. Cubans who were standing in line for remittances regretted the U.S. announcement, especially coming amid the COVID-19 pandemic.
I could be affected because I receive remittances from my children who live abroad, so I would be directly impacted.
The shutdown of Western Union would affect me because my relatives in the U.S. push themselves very hard to support me with some money which I badly need, and this U.S. decision would not be fair.
The U.S. Trump administration has taken aim at remittances before. Last year, limiting payments family members could send to Cuba to $1,000 per quarter. And earlier this year, it blocked Western Union from sending money to Cuba from any other country except the United States.
Cuban President Miguel Díaz-Canel condemned the latest U.S. move on his Twitter account. Under Trump, U.S.-Cuba ties have deteriorated, with Washington banning people-to-people visits, U.S. cruise trips, and limiting commercial airline flights. More Cuban companies have also been blacklisted by the current U.S. administration. Also this week, Marriott International said it was notified by Washington that it must close down its Four Point Sheraton Hotel in Havana by August 31st. Cuba, says this island economist, has little choice than to address challenges from within. I think the country needs structural reforms to get the most out of the productive forces, encourage all initiatives coming from the citizens, and generate more goods and services. There's been speculation that the latest U.S. moves may be aimed at pleasing the large Florida-based Cuban-American exile community in a state considered vital to Trump's re-election in November. But if true, the action could also backfire, as it stands to hurt their relatives here, ordinary Cubans. Luis Chirino, CGTN, Havana.